Hey, hello guys, and welcome in a new video. In the last video, we talked about delegate to runs and local connection. And in this video number 20, we are going to talk about the copy module. If you want, you can subscribe to my channel to not miss the next video, and you can like this video and comment it. First of all, if you want some documentation about the copy module, you can follow this link with the copy module page. And the purpose of the copy module, this is simply to copy a file or an entire directory on target servers. This is like a SCP command on Linux. This module takes some parameters. We show these parameters first of all. Attribute. If you want, you can change attribute or define attribute of the file or directory. This is like if you want, you can check the man page of change attribute command in Linux. Backup, if you want, you can copy your file or directory on target server, but before the copy, you can ask to Ansible to do a backup. A copy of the file before the change of file. So checksum, to check the integrity of the file with the hash of this file. Content, we'll show that in an example. If you want to create a file with a block or a variable, but not with a file. Decrypt, to decrypt the source file. By default, this parameter is set to yes, because Ansible decrypt all file if you encrypt this file with Vault Ansible Vault command. Directory mode, to copy an entire directory with a recursive mode. Okay, multi-file and all directories. The follow parameter to set the target file system. Force to replace the file if this file already exists or it is different from the source. The group, if you want to define the group of the file or directories. The local follow parameters to set the file system to use. The mode, if you want to set permissions of files and directories with two types, like with a number permission 0755, or if you want, you can use the POSIX format with U plus RWX and J plus RX and O plus RX. Okay, and you can define the owner, very important. And by default, if you don't set owner or group, this is by default the owner or the group of Ansible user on target server, okay, with SSH connection. Remote SRC, if you set it to no, you copy from our Ansible server or laptop on target server. But if you set this parameter to yes, you do a copy from the target server to the target server. This is like MV command on Linux for move or rename a file simply. src the path of the source file only, okay. Unsafe write to avoid the file corruption, and validate this is important if you use if you want to copy very important files like Sudoers for example, and you want to validate that your file is good, and to do it you can pass the validate parameter and you set a command to validate the copy of this file. Okay, we'll do some examples. So to do it, I use my script, my very useful script. I run, you can, if you want some information about this script, you can go into the 12 video, yes, yes, maybe 12 video, video number 12, sorry, and this script create some servers with Docker containers. Okay, so I run deploy.sh and I paste dash dash create option. So maybe I dropped before, okay, and I create, and I want to create three servers. Okay, I run it and I change my option, and I run now Ansible option, and now what I have in my directory, I have an Ansible directory with an inventory and a group vars and host vars if you want to use this inventory variables. Okay, so now I can go in Visual Studio Code, this is more more easy, and I add a new file, a playbook file. Okay, and now I can do my first example. So if you want, you can just do a copy of one file. I paste it here. Okay, so I must edit my playbook, which name my first playbook, for example, and on which target servers, whole servers. And now I can set some tasks, and my first task, and my first task is to use the copy module, okay? And I define my module, the copy module, and my source and my destination. By default, I think, be careful to the source location. By default, the source location is into the same of playbook directory. Or if you use a role, you have a file directory. And by default, when you use a role, Ansible use this directory, this files directory, okay? We'll see that in next video when we talked about roles, okay? So, to test it, I must create a test.txt file, okay? I create a new file, test.txt, like this. Okay, and I say hello world. Okay, so I save it, and now I can run it on my target, on my Ansible server. This is my laptop, and I use Ansible playbook command dash I to specify my inventory file. Ah, sorry, I'm not into Ansible directory. Okay, Ansible-playbook-i and my inventory and my playbook. Okay, so if I open and go in one of my three servers, I can go into 172.17.0.2, for example. If I check TMP directory like this, I don't have a xavki.txt file for now. Okay, I run my command. And now, if I check my output, I see I have a changed on the each server, .2, .3, .4. And if I check on one of these servers, if I do ls, I can find my file, /tmp, xavki, okay. Ah, sorry, I don't have, okay, ls. So I can do cat. Hello world. Okay, so I fix it now if you want. So I save it. Okay, so the next step, if you want, we can copy a tree with a recursive mode. To do it, I run mkdir and I create a tree with /tmp and subdirectory xavki and subdirectory 1, 2, 3. Very simple, okay. To do it, I copy this line. I go into my Ansible dir. I paste it. I run it. And now I do a tree. What I have a tmp directory. At the same level of my playbook, okay, and xavki and three directory 1, 2, 3, okay. So I can now use tmp slash, okay. I check my example, yes, and I want to copy it into /tmp like this, okay, and I run my command again and save it. I run it, okay, and I check now on my target server ls/tmp. In /tmp, I have now xavki directory. If I do ls on xavki directory, I have 1, 2, 3 directory. I have copied my directory with recursive mode, okay. So another example, if you want, you can use the remote src parameter. This is like mv command into Linux for move a file or some directories. To do it, I can copy it and paste it here, okay. Maybe source slash yes, we do that slash my example file /txt. I must create before on my server this file, okay. So to, yes, we can create this file with Ansible. It is more easy to create it with Ansible because we can do it manually, but very, very longer. Okay. Name, create example file. And so, example file, okay. And we use now the file module. We set the path. Into the path, we set home directory this file. So here, copy it. And we want only create this file with empty file. We use state parameters with touch option. Okay. So Now I run it again and I create the file, and after with copy module, the copy module, we change the directory of this file, okay? And now we have moved this file into /tmp directories. I check. And we have now this file here, okay? Another example, yeah. If you want, you can use, we have already seen loop and with item loop. So we can do an example with this loop. For example, we can do it. So what we do, we define a variable, this is my files variable, and in this variable we set the value to with a list of dictionary, you know, like a dictionary, Python dictionary, and we have some key, source, destination, and permission. We set it with XavKey 1 and XavKey 2, this is the source, and we want to copy this file. We can create I can remove the /tmp, remove, delete, okay, move to trash, okay, and now I want to create another folder. I create a folder /tmp. Into /tmp, I create a new file xavkey1.txt, and this is xavkey1, okay, and I want a second file, so I save it. Okay, so I remove this one. I copy that. Okay, I rename this one to XavKey2. Okay, this is just two file for example. And now I save it. Yes, I can set my playbook, my source. My source, this is. Here I use withItem loop with my file variable, and now I have an item variable, and I can use the key of my files variable. Okay, I use the source. So the source is /tmp tmp slash with item source, XavKey1 and XavKey2 in my loop. And the destination is into /tmp for XavKey1, and for XavKey2, we see we want to copy this file into my home directory, okay? And I set a permission with my loop, with item, and I set the mode. I define the mode to set permissions. So I run it again. Okay, I check the output, and I find into the output two tasks by server. We see .2 and .2 for XavKey1 and XavKey2, and I check the destination of each file, XavKey1 into /tmp and XavKey2 in my home. Okay, so I can now check on my server, ls /tmp. Okay, I find XavKey1 in /tmp, and if I check in my home, I have XavKey2. Okay, right. So maybe another example, if you want, you can use a better solution to do some iteration on file into a directory. To do it, you can do it like here. We use the copy module, we define the source, and I want to find some file into slash into tmp slash and xav key wildcard and txt or wildcard. I save it, and with this loop we do an iteration on xav key 1 and xav key 2 because we are in slash tmp directory, and we use wildcard. And if you want to add another file, Ansible discovery auto discover this file. Okay, so I save it, and this file is copied into slash tmp. So I run it again. Okay, we find two files by target server. If I check slash tmp, I have xav key 1 and xav key 2. Okay, perfect. So if I want, I can add, I can rename 3.yml. And if I run it again, and I check again, you can see the idempotence. Ansible don't do the task on each file already exist, but do the task for xav key 3, the new file. I do ls and I can find xav key 3.yml. Right. So if you want, you can do do a backup. Yes, to you can use the backup parameters. To do it, I set backup to yes. Okay, I save it, and I can do a change on xav key 1 file with second version of my file. Okay, I save it. So I go into a terminal. I run it again, and I change xav key 1. If I check into slash tmp, what I have xav key 1 file. Okay, but I have now the backup before. Before the change. Okay, if I check the content of this file, copy paste it, okay, like it, I have the previous version, and if I check my new file, I have the second version. Okay, right, very cool this parameter. And if you don't have a file from a source, if you have a variable, for example, of if you want to create a file with a block, you can do this example. So very important, the indentation. And now what we do, I define like a source, but this is the content of my target file. Hi, xav key team, we are on, and I use Jinja variable, okay? And I want to create a hello.txt file on slash tmp, okay? I run it again, and now I can check hello.txt file. Check we have hello.txt, and if I check the content of this file, I am on my server, okay, Oki Debian 1, and if I connect on another server, target server, I can check the 3, for example. If I do cat slash tmp hello.txt, this is my Ansible hostname variable. And I have use the content block. So another example. Yes, this is the validate command. Okay. If you want to use it, we can do this example. sorry. I'm not sure that works. Maybe. Okay. Can test it. So, what we do, we want to create with a source content source. We want to add a line, this line, for a DevOps user. I want to add our OK user because I'm OK. Okay, so I want my OK user have no password permission. So to do it, I add a file named DevOps, okay, into sudoers.d directory. But sudoers is very, very important. Before to do this change, I want to check if my file is right. To do it, what I do, I add validate parameters with a command. This is the vi sudo command, and I add some option to check my file. Percentage s is my target file on my target server, and this is like we do like it. Okay, so I save it. I run it again. So maybe an error. Maybe we have already set this line in our sudoers near like line one. So this is an example. I'm not sure. Fail to validate. Okay. This is the check, and the check tell me this line doesn't work, and Ansible doesn't copy. In this case, doesn't copy the target file. Okay. So if you check, I can do ls on slash /etc slash sudo earth dot d. And we don't find the new file because our validate command doesn't work. It's simply a simple example. Okay, and that's all for today, I think. Yes. So if you want to find these slides, you can follow the link in the video description. Thank you for watching this video. You can like it and comment. Don't miss the next one. I say you goodbye. Thank you.